大家好，我是邓领斌，欢迎回到我的频道。上星期 Ford 终于出了他们的 F-150 的电车版，我们首先来看一看他的 commercial。 Electric is
It's time to say Hold up, wait a minute, something ain't right。
哇，这个开头跟 Cybertruck 简直是一模一样，当日 Cybertruck 的 teaser 广告就是这样。好了，我们继续。 What it can do It's time for electric To turn into lightningAn electric truck that can match the ambitions of this nation. That can haul on both ends. Extensive resume. Help build your house. And if need be. 咁佢呢度 show 俾我哋睇嘅 Pack to House， 我会喺另一条 F-150 同 Cybertruck comparison 嘅片入边再讨论。It's a big ridiculous smile on your face every time you hit the accelerator. 咁佢嘅馬力就一定要講啦。That feels like a bullet and works like a freight train. The only EV quick enough, smart enough to carry our name. V that's an F-150. 咁佢嘅插電器都會喺後邊討論嘅。The fully electric F-150.虽然已经有很多外国的 YouTuber 已经报道了他了，但是未必个个都会看英文频道的，所以我就想用中文跟大家讨论一下。那为什么大家会急 engage 呢？就其实是因为大家都很期待 Ford 可以做些什么车出来去砌 Tesla 的 Cybertruck、 Rivian 的 Pickup Truck R1T 和 GMC 的 Hummer。 因为美国的 Pickup Truck Market 都会很大，因为很多 Family 都会有几部车，除了四人车和 SUV 之外，很多时候都会有部 Truck 够大够方便去搬嘢。咁點解今次 Ford 出 Electric Pickup Truck 會咁受大家關注呢？因為 Ford 嘅 F-Series 係 Pickup Truck 之中賣得最多嘅車，咁佢每年係講緊賣70-80万部 F-Series 啦。所以當初 Tesla 出 Pickup Truck 嘅時候，佢哋就拎咗 Cybertruck 同 F-Series 俾咯。咁本身 Cybertruck 就係喺2019年11月出嘅，出嗰日嘅直播自己都有睇。咁如果你嗰日冇睇到，咁我而家可以放少少俾大家睇下咯。
Welcome to the Cybertruck unveil. I love you guys too. I love you guys too. Hey. Trucks have been the same for a very long time. For like 100 years. Trucks have been basically the same. We want to try something different. I'll show you what trucks do. You see trucks all the time. Another reminder. Let's play that line. Yeah. So.It's actually hard to tell. It's hard to tell which is which, really. We took the brands off, but it's hard to tell which is which with the brands off. They'll pretty much look the same. We need something different. And we need sustainable energy now. If to solve sustainable energy, we have to have a pickup truck. So I present to you the Cybertruck.Doesn't look like anything else. The functionality I'm going to describe is within a space that is less than the most popular pickup truck in the United States, the F-150. We moved the mass to the outside, created an exoskeleton. So normally, the way that a truck is designed, you have a body on frame, you have a bed on frame, and the body and the bed don't do anything useful. They're carried like cargo, like a sack of potatoes. The key to creating an effective monoplane was a stressed skin design. You move the stress to the outside skin. It allows you to do things that you can't do with a body on frame. So we're able to make the skin out of ultra-hard stainless steel. We're going to show you just how hard.
佢真係一錘揼落去都冇嘢嘅喎。
Pretty strong.
What if we shot it? That's a 9mm bullet shot at the door. It is literally bulletproof to a 9mm handgun. That's how strong the skin is. It's ultra hard, cold rolled, stainless steel alloy that we've developed. We're going to be using the same alloy in the Starship rocket and in the Cybertruck. On the right, that's normal for the truck doors, like nice and well made of tissue paper. That looks like a paintball, very different. So, you know, when you say something is cold tough, that's what we mean.Transparent metal glass. Let's show the glass demo. Franz, could you try to break this glass, please?
Sure. Yeah.
Oh my fucking god. Well, maybe that was a little too hard.
Should we try on the floor?
Sorry? No.It didn't go through. That's a plus side.
Let's try the right.
Try that one, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, man.
It didn't go through. All right. Not bad. Room for improvement. We could actually throw everything through wrenches, we threw everything, even the pulleys through the same stuff that we threw through the glass. And it didn't break. For a weird reason it broke down.In addition, the car has an adaptive air suspension. This will come standard on all the cars because every truck has the ability to adjust the ride height. So you can be efficient on the highway and you can also go off-roading. It's going to have highest clearance of any production truck. It would have a 16-inch clearance. You can adjust this on the fly. So it's adaptive damping and an adaptive ride height. Talk about that truck bolt. Demo this active damping. The rear is 100 cubic feet, 6.5 foot bearing, up to 3,500 pounds payload.
What about
real world test? Let's actually have a tug of war here with the F-150. See which one can pull which. Yeah. It was uphill. The onward. Okay, we can give the Porsche a little bit of a head start.This is a Condoza current pull. And this is the actual truck, not CGI. You know, free ranges. So obviously, you'll have access to all the superchargers, be capable of more than 240 kilowatts. We'll reveal the actual later. It has onboard outlets for 110 and 220 volts. So you don't need a generator. And a little plus, because it's got an air suspension, you can tap off the air suspension so you have a pneumatic or an onboard air compressor. Of course, it will come with autopilot standard.
Plugged in a charger.
All right. Thank you.
好啦，咁一开始 Cybertruck 出嚟嗰阵，我真系有少少懊悔嘅。但系成部嘢越睇我就觉得佢越特别。咁而家已经系成为咗一个 icon 啦。Tesla 佢哋喺活动开头都提咗一个好大嘅问题，就系啲 pickup truck 过咗百几年都系同一个样。咁 Elon Musk 就觉得系时候要改变一下大家对 pickup truck 嘅刻板形象，所以佢就要 design 一样唔同嘅嘢出嚟。咁佢就唔想俾舊有嘅 design 帶領住，佢就 follow 咗兩套佢細個中意嘅電影汽車去 design 佢嗰部 Cybertruck， 融合咗上一代對未來科技嘅幻想，又不失 Cyberpunk 2077嘅感覺。而且佢真系一锤揼落去都完全冇事，所以上一条片喺 Tesla Energy 最后讲到 Cybertruck 嘅表面系防刮花，我系绝对相信嘅，而且效果会比任何嘅 Ford Truck 都要好咯，因为佢系用紧 SpaceX 嘅火箭级 Stainless Steel。
咁点解 Ford 一出啲人就疯狂报道呢？好明显就系因为 Cybertruck 发布会嗰日用咗 F150 嚟拍咗条短片，示范咗佢哋嘅扭力系强过 Ford 嘅 F150 几多。
咁條片就係喺個斜坡上面拍嘅， Cybertruck 就係向上，而 Ford 就係向下。咁大家一開始睇到好興奮呢，就係因為 Ford 係完全冇機會完全輸曬， Cybertruck 一扯就扯咗部 Ford 走。但係之後啲人就話 Ford 其實係 rear wheel drive， 所以佢哋能力根本就係唔對等嘅，因為 Cybertruck 係 all wheel drive， 咁香港一般會叫做四輪驅動。咁以後我哋可以睇下佢哋公布嘅 spec 啦，可以睇到到底其實 Cybertruck 係咪真係唔夠做，所以先揾一架廢啲嘅 pickup truck 去同佢比。咁 F150 就有四個 trim level 嘅，第一個就係 basic 嘅最平嘅 level。就是39,000美金起嘅，然后到 XLT 嘅 trim level 就系53,000美金起嘅，然后到第三个嘅价钱仲未公布，然后到最尾最高级嘅就系 platinum 就系90,000蚊起步嘅。咁以上全部都系 standard range 个价啦 ，extended range 个价就仲未公布嘅。咁 standard range 同 extended range 分别就系230 miles 同300 miles 啦，即系370公里同埋482公里左右。而佢哋官网话佢哋最低级嘅 base trim level XLT。同埋 Lariat 嘅級數係只有230 miles 嘅 version， 而你要係去到最頂端嘅 Platinum， 你先可以揀到482公里嘅 battery pack。咁有啲人就 assume 要額外加多10,000蚊左右，都係咁嘅話，佢哋所謂最平嘅482公里將會有一個63,000美金嘅 base price。咁如果 on range 計嘅話 ，Ford 嘅 F150 佢最長嘅距離300 miles 就同 Cybertruck 嘅 Dual Motor 係同級，但係價錢就貴咗10,000美金。所以如果係咁，佢哋所謂最平嘅300 miles 車，其實基本係要63,000美金。咁講到呢度都差唔多啦。總結翻呢條片就係、是、其實有 competitor 其實係一件好事嚟嘅。Elon Musk 本身都支持有 competitor 嘅，原因係有 competitor 就可以促進推動成個美國走向綠色新能源。另外冇對比就冇傷害，如果冇撇屎出嚟，你又點知道花香呢？當成個電車界得 Tesla 係努力緊嘅時候，佢係第一間一定會遇到好多問題嘅。但係佢啲問題就俾嗰啲食屎媒體去放大曬佢哋，其實仲係間接用你哋自己老牌公司屙嘅屎去證明 Tesla。It's actually a better option. 咁我哋下一条片再见啦，拜拜。